Tony, you notice it's getting darker?
Yeah, I did notice that, actually.
I love how subtle it is.
Yeah, it's the sunset is pretty. It's currently 23 degrees Celsius outside. Whatever that converts to.
That's got to be like 80 something.
Brent, are you in the same practice session as us?
74 in here.
I'm in a race.
Oh, cool. What's your fastest lap time so far?
Hold on.
.118 Yeah. Yeah, you got me beat. I'm at .119.3 I think I'm going to have to start getting a little more aggressive in the first chicane.
You all want to do a pit party?
Yep, I'm in.
Let's see, I'm sitting here in the second box.
Oh, okay. I'll make my way up.
I'm passing turn one now.
I wish there was a display on your dash that told you how much up or down brake bias you are.
There is. Oh, you mean on the actual dash? Yeah. I don't even think there's a sim. I guess you have to use one of the crew chief at things or in sim racing to figure that out.
No, there's a plus or minus. Plus or minus 3 in one of the boxes.
Yeah, but you have to have it in the black box. You don't have it on the dash. So far, I haven't been getting loose on the braking, so I might try rolling it back a little.
the setup does not feel right going from the road part to the oval part.
I'm sure it's fine-tuned for the road part. As fine-tuned as can be, I guess, on such short notice. Oh, no. You know that thing I said about not getting loose under braking? It just happened going into the second chicane. I tried to really, really push it in there. And it rejected me. It was going to be my fastest lap, too. I was going to crack 118. Blah.
Yay, I got an official lap time.
No, oh, he just hopped the turtle hard. I saw sparks.
Christ. About blew my eardrums out.
I did, sorry.
You about scared me. Hot damn.
No! Oh, I didn't think you were still there, sorry. Spotter's not doing a good very job here.
You know, the good news is if you clip in that second chicane, if you clip that first hurdle on your exit, you can just jump over
especially
that
on my
last
rift.
One.
And when I first launch from the garage, I get about a 1 second freeze. Probably going to have to crank a setting down. It's really hard to engine brake the last chicane. Because it's such an off camp, it's just such a weird braking zone. It's kind of a downhill braking zone. Ooh, I just hopped that last curb like you were talking about. No penalty. I did get an off track, I think.
Well, P5.
Well done.
P5 on the lead lap. I'll take it, I guess.
I may run one here in a second. I still got a lot to learn, I think. The last chicane, I don't really feel comfortable with yet.
Are you guys still in 671?
Yes. If it's full, let us know and I'll hop to a different room. Just turned to 117.6. Okay, I think I've picked something out up for the final chicane. Braking zone and your off-gas zone are not the same. At least it works for me to let off a little sooner but brake a little later. It makes it feel a lot more stable that way. So they completely basically repaved the inside, didn't they?
Yeah, they repaved the entire thing.
Say what?
Yeah, they repaved the entire thing on the inside.
I mean, it's been a long time since I ran the old Charlotte Road course, but it doesn't feel the same at all. That being said, well, I never ran it in a cup car.
Well, this is an entirely new course. I mean, not entirely. I mean, there's bits and pieces of the old one, but this one, for the majority, is...
I just got to start really fine-tuning my braking points. I think that's where I am now. I'm getting to where none of the turns are a surprise to me anymore. Were you able to get in here?
No, I'm doing something else quick.
Uh-oh, Tony got dropped.
Yeah, I think it's time. It's telling me I need to go to bed.
Getting early starting the morning to you, Tony?
Yep, always about 3:30.
Oh, geez. Yeah.
Well, you boys
breaking
have a good
around
night.
The two sign in turn one.
Talk to you later, man. It was fun crashing this place with you.
I know, I saved a couple of good replays.
Oh, I had a decent long run going there.
Damn it, I swear, I've yet to complete that second fucking bus stop thing.
Try, I don't know. Actually, let me go back and watch my replay, and I'll try to tell you what my marks are. I'm going to have to turn a graphic setting down somewhere.
New full-time cup team, number 77, next year.
Who's owner?
Fire Sports and Entertainment. It's an agency that works with sponsors and drivers.
Oh, that don't sound so good.
All right, Tony. I got my replay going here. If I come out of the second turn, I'm listening. I let out of the gas, I don't know. Do you see, if you look at the blue line, are you on the track or you want to look in detail with me here? So I'm trying to help you out with this mark
I'm
here.
just coming up to that corner right now, actually.
Okay. Well, the stuff that help you get on the pit road, there's a triple dash marker and a double dash marker. And the double dash marker is right where the blue line ends. Okay, I'm letting go at the triple dash marker. That's the one before that.
Okay.
Okay, I let off the throttle there. And then I get on the brake around the black sign after it, almost right where pit road starts.
Okay.
And I'm not getting far enough over to the left, but that's giving me a little bit of a stable entry without it getting loose. So you let off at that triple marker, and then you get on the brake right before the black sign goes out of vision. And that seems to be the most stable entry for me. And that's with my brake bias turned back 3% from the default. So let me know if that helps you.
You know what? I think it did because I did complete that chicane there, and that's pretty much where I was hitting those marks. My problem, I was just not getting slowed up enough, so I kept blowing the exit out of that.
Yeah, but there's also the matter of, I don't know, in road course racing, you really have to start to establish where your marks are, or because if you overshoot it in any car, you can't brake and turn. You're going to spin, or you're going to miss the turn.
Well, it's the same in the oval. It may not be as catastrophic, but you got to hit your marks, otherwise you're going to fuck up that turn and lose a lot of positions.
Yep, but when you do it in a road, you go off course. Oh shit! Woo! I just did a dirt track around turn one. Guy wrecked in front of me, so this is not going to be a hot lap. And then the infield on both of those, after the, all the right-handers, don't be afraid to use all of the track, even the painted stuff. Oh wow! I almost nailed the turtles in the first chicane. Oh, another correction. Woo. What time is it? Oh, crap. I didn't activate crew chief yet. What time is it, guys?
Almost 8:15.
So there'll be a race at 30? Is there one every half hour?
No idea.
Just got down into the 16s, 116.2.
115.9.
Ah, fuck you.
115.8.
You got a 115, Tony? Hell yeah.
No, fuck no. I just wanted to say a lower number than you guys.
Damn, I was going to be proud for you for a second. You just like, made me sad.
Me and road courses don't get along, so it's not much of a surprise. I'd hoot and holler if I could get under a minute 20.
I think I'm going to go sign up for the next race. Now, I wonder if I just stay in this session and just withdraw. I can sign up for the race and not actually exit the practice, right?
Yeah, that entire front stretch is all AstroTurf. I just stopped on that bitch like it meant.
More grip on the AstroTurf than the grass? Now, did you get that 115 in the same track as me?
No.
What's your temperature?
I have no idea. I backed out of it already. I was doing a qualifying.
Okay. And it also might be a greener track, too. More grip. I just saw a weird graphical artifact. Like, the track was, I don't know, doing a weird shimmery thing. Oop. I just tried to shift with my paddle. All me, bro. Sorry. It's nice running by you, though. We're not too far off in speed. Where's the tires that everybody was hitting?
I would have to think that'd be the tires coming out of that first chicane. I've smacked those a time or seven.
Figured a little something out after turn one too. Don't try to gas it going with a wheel even slightly turned. Just gas a little bit right along the wall and then let off the gas and turn in. Overdrove that corner. What time is it? What time is it? Whoop! Jeez. Was it the tire wall that you were stuck on?
Yep.
Okay. I guess that chicane is just not giving me fits, so it's a very high speed chicane.
Go faster.
Well,
you'll find it.
There's really only two turns in it. It's not a typical chicane. You can get through it. You can just kind of do a left and a right and get through it. It doesn't behave like, for me, it doesn't feel like the bus stop at Watkins Glen where it's a three turn chicane. What time is it? Pow! That hurts. I did try pushing it a little bit faster through the chicane, first chicane. It didn't work. I didn't
hit
the
tires.
No, I found the outside wall.
Oh, okay. Well, keep trying, man. I got faith. You'll find those tires.
It should be in like an achievement unlocked. They should add it to the iRacing achievements. Stuck on the tires at the Roval. What time is it? So this is just to the stream, if anybody's watching the stream. Yeah, I'm wrecking a lot, but I understand the track, and I'm really just trying to test limits now. How deep can I drive it? How much brake can I put into it before it spins? I'm trying to see how late I can push that first chicane. And downshifting in the second chicane is still a little tricky. I haven't quite figured out the best way to time it, because I like to engine brake, but it makes the car so unstable there. And right there, I just tried going between the 4 and the 5, and it's just too much speed. I'm getting unstable on the right-hand turn. I'm going to try halfway between one more time. Whoop.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Hey, Mason.
How we doing?
Roveling it up. Oh, man. I didn't listen to my own advice in turn one that time. What time is it?
Hey, David, remember not to just gas it with the wheel turned at all, eh?
Yep, sounds better coming from you with that you pretty go. Canadian accent.
Hey, I don't have an accent.
You're right. I'm the one who has the accent.
Yeah, you do.
All right, it's race time. I'll be right back as it loads.
Is the beta UI worth it?
I don't know. I mean, if you're setting up a hosted session and you want to have control of a lot of the settings, I guess you have no choice.
Should it be telling me no race data on the website?
No, that's strange.
Yeah. I'm gonna log out, log back in. Try that. Yep, no race data.
Have you already patched?
Oh, well, it's because I didn't have Rookie Series turned on.
Right, be right back.
Fucking idiot.
What's running the Roval?
The A-car?
What?
Is it in the
Carb Cup?
No, it's the A-car. Well, I mean, yeah, they're the same thing, aren't they? Qualified P1, Tony.
Nice.
No, well, I guess, yeah. The only good thing is hopefully I don't run into anybody. Hopefully they...
You might make it through turn one.
Yeah, I know. A track temp of 93 degrees. Oh my god.
What'd you say? Oh, yeah, the track is 10 degrees Celsius hotter than the practice was. Fuck me. I'd like to apologize, especially since the track is 10 degrees Celsius hotter than it was in practice. Jimmy, where'd you get the Roval fixed? It's a diagonal grid, just like the new Pocono. In fact, we're gridding in a chicane, it looks like. Yeah, we're gridding in the second chicane. Do the chicanes have nicknames yet?
Rec 1 and Rec 2.
Well, the first one could be called The Wall.
Well,
hey, I'm winning this on lap one.
And
I'm telling you right now.
And I missed the pole by 1/1000th of a second. Never mind. Never mind. I missed it by quite a bit now.
Are you guys gonna race again?
I just realized you can never go through a chicane at the same speed, two wide, as you can one wide.
Sure.
All right, I'll practice then.
Monza last week, and
what are they like five GTE lap races?
Was a wreck there almost every time.
15. This will probably go past that 20-minute mark. Stuff like that.
Well, yeah, 20 laps or 15 laps, but they're well close. Yeah, because it's close to a minute and a half. Is that installable? I heard there was some kind of upgrade on the V3 pedals. Is that just the inverters, or can you do that on the regular
ones? Backstretch? That's nice of them. For the front
stretch. You would like the bushes.
A little bit is okay, all right? It's when it starts getting out of control that I have issue with.
I'm seeing like discoloration on the track. And I didn't hear what y'all said because I was listening to the guys in the room. Is there a quick repair?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry, I tried to hit the mute button. I didn't get there in time. Wow, the green is going to come out in the first chicane, or the second chicane.
Yeah, there's definitely races in the beta UI that there's not on the website. Or at least... maybe I'm just looking in the wrong spot.
Yo, I hit the turtles. I just blew it. I'm just going to go get the quick repair so I can turn it into a practice session. Pit stop, clear all. Pit stop, clear all.
I got a 13-second lead on lap two.
I don't. I've wrecked in turn one. Or after turn one. I don't know where pit entry is. What?
Couldn't it be the normal?
Was it before the chicane or after the chicane?
Normal pit road, right?
It's going to be before.
Found it.
Really don't even know why I bother with these races. I can barely get through to lap one.
sometimes it's oh, that's weird. My guy didn't drop the sign. Hey, it didn't use my fast repair. What the hell?
Yeah, the sign is gone too.
Yeah, the sign is gone. The fast repair, I mean, I guess it must have cleared it when I said clear all.
Well, boys, that's it for me tonight. Y'all have a good
and
one.
And my HUD keeps blinking, flickering.
Like later, it's trying, Tony.
Like it's trying to start and stop. Should I let the 2 minutes repair? No, I want the fast repair. I'm just going back out again. Pit stop, clear all.
What setup do they let you use in the race?
I'm using the one that's on our drive.
Oh, so it's open setups?
Yes. In fact, supposedly the fixed setup's not even right yet. I'm getting some terrible FPS here. I think I'm going to have to turn a crowd or something down. Boy, that's tough to do without the pit stop sign.
Yeah, this setup can be so much better. It should not be. It should not be hopping over that right front, going onto that front stretch.
Any ideas on how to fix it?
No, not off the top of my head.
I wonder if VRS will hop on it.
Oh, that chicane is scary.
Definitely going to have to back my marks up. Oh.
Oh, yeah, you're right. This front end is like bouncing like crazy.
Yeah, it's rolling over that right front pretty bad, huh?
Both ones. Did we try any other road course setups?
Yeah, Sonoma and Watkins Glen. When you're on the oval part of the track, it just hits the bottom the entire time. So like it's bottoming it out and the banking and all that.
I'll be back.
Oh shit. I was looking at my time stuff and blasted right through the second chicane horribly. And it punishes you hard. Yeah, it's no sports car. Oh, I'm getting a blue flag. Not cool. I didn't know they had that turned on stock cars. It never showed up at Watkins Glen. Wish Hammer was home. Starting to really feel skatey already. Oh, shit. I just ended up in the Legends track. Facing the right direction. Ow. And I'm done. Whew. Well, first race is always a learning session.
I just got fucking taken out by a guy that...
Well, let's run another one. Let's see. Yeah, 2 minutes to get in. And I'll be right back. So if Fanatec says they won't send a cheap base until the DD1s are done, I might just see what I can find on eBay and tell them to send me the Porsche, send me the rim anyway.
I'll be shocked if they do. You know, many people are probably asking the same thing.
Oh, how cool. In the Oculus, I can actually look at my avatar in the mirror in the little room that I'm in.
Did you guys make the race?
I just finished winning one. I did not make this one.
Congrats. So, someone in the other room was saying that there's a setup for the other cars, but just not the Camaro?
No, there's one for the Camaro. Huh. That's the one that's in the drive.
I got that one. But they were just saying that there wasn't one for the Camaro, like in the setup folder.
Oh, you're talking about on iRacing?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, there's not. There is, though, Tony said that there is, if you go into practice, or test mode, like if you're in test mode, he said you can get it in there.
Are you in this race, Mason?
Yep.
All right.
What kind of lap time are you running?
On a cool track, I got a 1.7 or a 1.16.2. That track was hot, and I had not run a hot track or run in traffic, and I just blew it.
Mason, what's your password?
I think I said it to Fosse, too.
Wrong.
Music 24, then.
All right. I'm going to look at the graphic settings. I think I'm going to have to turn something down. I already have crowds on low detail. I'm going to turn off two pass trees. What else can I mess with? I don't see anything I want to turn off.
Are you having issues with it?
I am now.
I have, that's weird. Did you run the graphics configuration?
No, I have everything already, almost all the way up to max.
I would try to rerun your graphics configuration. Because I reran mine and I'm getting everything. I got everything maxed out. Almost everything.
Well, it's not doing so well in the Rift. Well, I don't know. I was seeing some choppiness, but mainly when I click when I enter the grid, it hangs for a while.
Oh yeah, mine does that too. It hangs for about 5 seconds, and then it's good.
Yep.
You want to know what's wrong with the setup, Brent?
What?
Take a look at the shock spring. Zero.
I'll look at that here in a second. All right. Fucking rolling right over the top of it, man. That's probably why. I think we need to stiffen that bad boy up.
Like a damn pogo stick.
Road racers prefer the stiffer you can make it, the better.
Currently zero stiffness. Wait, what? How am I P1? How do they determine who qualified first?
If I was you, I'd get out there then. Yeah.
How?
Hey, do you see where you're at right now on the track?
Yeah.
Okay, so that green flag is going to drop way before this point.
Yeah.
So that green flag is ninth
on the grid and was in the middle of the chicane when it dropped.
That green flag is going to drop almost right at the end of the pit road. And if I was you, I would try to get a good jump.
Holy shit. Is it just because I went on the track first?
No.
No, there's actually separate qualifying sessions.
Oh. Well, I didn't run those.
But like in my race, only one person has a qualifier recorded. So it's probably done by iRating. If nobody's qualified, they're having it where you have qualifying is a completely different time now instead of in the same in once a session. You just set a qualifying for the whole week.
Well, can you hear this guy, Brent?
Nah, I muted him.
I just don't want to wreck in front of the whole field.
Oh, my God. I almost wrecked on the pace lap.
Try to get that jump, man.
Second gear?
I did first. Try it right here on the straightaway here.
Well, that's good. I'm
only getting 42 frames per second. I turned the mirrors on. That definitely didn't help. I guess I'll run the graphics config and see what happens.
So it's going to start soon. Is that what you said?
What's that?
So it's going to start on this back here?
No, not on the back. No, I'll let you know.
Okay.
When you're coming out of turn three, it'll start. I'll let you know. I mean, it's not going to start before the pace car pulls off. That'd be ridiculous. Yeah. Come on now.
We were in the chicane when it started.
I need to turn these people down. Chat's way too loud. Do we really have to make pit stops?
No, you don't.
Oh, okay. He's just being a jackass then.
Caster's at 8.9 degrees. Like, that seems like an awfully lot.
What's the track temp?
Anytime this car goes, I would, whenever you want. There you go.
Almost missed it, huh?
And they're wrecking in turn one. Woo, I got through.
Shit, he just about jacked you up.
Should have turned the auto clutch on. I want to get on it so hard coming out of that corner.
Oh, they wrecked in the... There's a car sitting on top of the tire wall there. He did his Tony impression.
Oh.
New leader. Ride it out. There you go. It's fucking Tokyo Drift, this bitch.
You're probably used to Daytona where you can really gun it coming up on the banking. You can't do that here. Or you'll slap the fuck out of the wall. just turned to 17.9. And then I almost spun in the next lap. Oh, shit. Thanks for the boost. I was spinning and a guy rear-ended me and straightened me back out. Oh my god.
That sucked.
Huh?
Cut the track.
Yeah, it is. There's some places where I'm getting loose where I didn't in any of the practices. Or even last race. Oh, no, 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 no. I got wheel hops downshifting. I was closing good on a guy, too.
You still watching, Brent?
I am, question mark.
Yeah, lap car coming out before me there.
I did not see that. No, I'm. Truth is, I was trying to get a good video. Trying to get a good video. You going through that chicane?
I don't know if you'll find one.
Yeah, there's some places where that hopping on the infield is actually hurting me.
Hell, if I was you, Mason, I almost let this guy go. You've got an 11-second lead.
Here I am, supposed to be the road guy, and y'all are the ones getting wins in the fucking road course.
Oh, don't worry, you're still better than us. I suck in these cars.
Seem to avoid I don't know the numbers of the turns here, but one of the right-handers in the infield, I turned a little earlier, even though I didn't brake a little earlier, and I seemed to avoid a bump that was upsetting the car really bad. Oh, shit. That feeling when you know you broke too late on the coming into the chicane?
Pretty scary.
I just went ahead and took the penalty. If I'd have tried to made it, I would have wrecked.
About what, 7 seconds?
No, the first chicane's not too bad. It was only like 1.2. That second chicane will kick your ass, though. It's about 5 seconds. And it's hard to make it up. You really have to almost stop.
Mason, did you see where that guy hit?
No.
So he hit that wall right there. When you go around there, if you look, there's a caution light, a green caution light. And if you hit where that caution light is, that caution light will stop your car instantly.
I get Grandpa out here in that chicane.
I saw that, yeah.
I ain't taking any chances.
Not with a 14-second lead.
I'm in seventh now. I also have the leader 6 seconds behind me. Actually, I'm in eighth. Crew chief is still screwing up. I know. I see what you're talking about that insane wheel hop going up onto the track. It's just making it so tight.
That was a good lap. Damn it.
Done that a time or two. That's what I mean. Like, I feel like there should be more grip right there than what there is.
Yeah. Well, it bounces. That's what it was doing to me.
Yeah, that's what.
You're talking about the last turn before the oval, right?
Yeah, that left-hander. Where it transitions from the road to the...
That time it didn't bounce too bad on me. I don't know what I did different.
Corner right there, Mason.
It's just going up and down like crazy when you go over track surfaces.
I just looked at your replay. That first, that second turn number two. Your left rear was off the ground completely.
Seriously?
Yeah.
I just got lapped. In position 7.
How?
Huh?
Not you. The left rear being off the ground.
Yeah, it looks like the left rear is off the ground. Even when you go through that that left-hander that you just went through.
Yeah.
All right, the leader that I was following, he got as close to that inside wall as he could going up onto the curb, going up onto the oval.
One lap. That's probably why it spins around here, then. The left rear's not touching.
I think there's way too much caster in the car, just the way that the tire looks.
P7. Fastest lap on that one was a 117.7. All right, where's the configurator? Is it in the folder?
I That was a good time.
Oh my god! What the fuck was that? Yeah, well done, man.
Thank you.
I'm telling you, dude. P1's good here. If you qualify.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, you're sitting down right now where you are. Even your left rear looks like it's off the ground still.
What?
Might be a rendering issue.
Oh man, that was hard. I mean, that Mitchell guy should have won. He was faster. But he couldn't keep it on the road.
I'm looking for the graphics program. I'm not seeing it.
Are you to run the graphics?
Yeah.
Go into your settings. On that, up at the top of the screen, or like...
What, like in the game?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I guess I'm going to have to load
it. Well, no, not in the game. Like, open up your, the member website. That's on that tab. Okay. It's the far right-hand tab. Where you got your home, official races, hosted, all that stuff.
All right. How do I tell it to look for the rift? I don't know which. I've got display 1, 2, and 3, but I don't know which one is which.
That I do not know.
I think everybody's finished the race. I already got 2x from spinning it sideways there.
Got one more car. Backed out.
Got one more car here.
You gonna run the next one?
Yeah.
I think we missed it, didn't we?
The 9 o'clock one.
Oh. I suppose.
Alright, I'm gonna go qualify then real quick.
Yeah, same. So that actually changes.
Did you get
the
pictures?
Resolution setting, doesn't it? That
yeah.
That, the graphics configurator?
Yeah.
What can you change on the setup for qualify? Because you can't dump fuel.
Good
tire
add tape.
Up maybe.
Tire
yeah,
pressures.
Add tape
yeah.
And tire pressures.
Yeah.
How many clicks do you usually push the tire pressures up?
I usually do about 3. Maybe 2. I guess between 2 to 4.
Got a good Metallica song playing on the phone right now. And Justice for All. Off the first album I owned. How cheap... first of all, I wonder if the Porsche rim will go on any... Will it go on any of the bases? Even like the little CSL one?
I do not know.
Because worst comes to worst, if I can find a used one for less than 100, I'll just say Fanatec, send me the rim now, and sip.
Brent, when I'm doing the picture cropping, what did you want to choose after that? I click crop, then what?
16x9.
So is it just gonna sit on preparing session until 8:35? I guess.
Yeah. Yep.
All right. I'll be right back.
When's the next race start? What are we doing?
9 o'clock. I'm qualifying. Doing the 8:35 qualifying session real quick.
Where is that at?
If you go under official races thing, like where it has a list of all the races going on, if you click on the qualify tab, it'll list them all on there.
There's a qualify tab?
You know, like on the top right under the race now button?
Oh, you're on the member site.
Yeah.
See, I'm not seeing these.
Are you on the member site right now?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're under the race now tab?
Yeah.
America Robo 400 qualifying.
Got it.
Yeah. We're doing the 835 one.
So in 10 minutes.
Right now.
I don't have that one.
It sucks. It's working.
Does it matter which one I choose?
No, it doesn't. No. Oh, you get four laps, so you get your four best laps in.
Okay.
By the way, the guy that qualified had a time of 1:13 in my session.
It's cruising.
So I looked at the Robo setup. It's got, what, seven in the back, seven ride height. The Watkins Glen one had like six, so hey, could probably jack it up.
You know what just dawned on me? The resolution that that configurator recommended is way, way, way higher than the Rift's Revolution.
Yeah, you're gonna, you can change that resolution, so.
Yeah, I may need to turn it down, because the Rift's is only like 1020 on the lower number.
Yeah.
That probably give me a much better performance. In fact, according to Google, I'll look in a second. I can't get over to the, I can't get my cursor to go over to the, there we go. Will it make it with 100% tape?
I don't think so. It's four laps.
So where are you going?
I bumped it up to 35. I was going to do 50 at first. I still don't think that'll make it.
I'll go for 50, YOLO. Actually, that's not true. You can qualify multiple times. Now, I don't, maybe it's because there's not as many cars on here, but it loaded a lot quicker when I pushed qualify.
Have we checked out setup sync?
I did not.
I mean, I doubt anyone put anything up there, but you never know.
My second lap sucks, so I'm actually going to creep into the chicane so I can get a better third lap.
Oh wow, you get the F1 wheel for free?
Yeah.
Shit. I thought it was just a random wheel.
And it's going to be the 2019, which is going to be similar to that 18 that we were covering with the insane amount of buttons. So, right, my plan now is if they don't offer to send me a cheap base for a while, I'm just going to buy one somewhere. Used. Do you still have your 2.5?
Yep.
But you're using that now, right?
Yep.
Will the other base hold Fanatec wheels?
I don't see why it wouldn't.
Have you already sold it?
Oh, no, the Thrustmaster? No.
Yep, my first lap is going to be my best lap. I'm already a whole second off final lap. Boink, 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 boink. Did you set a time, Brent?
God damn it. If I fucking get one more off track, I'm gonna fuck it. Ugh.
I guess he didn't set a time.
Fucking bullshit off track.
So did you miss all your laps?
Yeah, every one of them.
Did you actually get a 117, 175, or is my thing just off?
I mean, I probably got a 117, but nowhere near was it a fast lap. What did it say? Did it say I got a 117?
Well, on the standing, on my standings app, on the sim racing apps, it says we have the exact same time.
Oh, down, that's probably an error then.
Down to the thousandth.
$116.0.
All right, 1080 by 116.0. Damn, good job. You got me by a second. Um. The panels have a refresh rate of 90 hertz.
Your what?
The Oculus Rift panels actually refresh at 90 hertz.
Okay.
So I'm going to run this configurator again and see if I can get it set right. Because I don't need a huge resolution, just 1080 by 1200, right? There's no reason to overscan it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I can't change the resolution. Maybe I have to do that actually in game.
Which way do I want to go on the configurator? Numbers.
Only gives me one choice.
Gear numbers. Which way do I want to go to make it take longer to peak?
I have no idea.
You want to make it longer?
Yeah. So 4.7 instead of 4.6?
I think so. No, the higher the number, the more the shorter the gear is actually, isn't it?
Alright, we'll give her a shot here. See what happens. Just hitting the chip.
Did you go to 4.7?
That's all right. 4.6.
Are you trying to lower it?
No, I'm trying to make it take just a hair longer.
Oh.
Okay, yeah, I have no choice to change the resolution and options.
Even in the sim?
Even in the sim.
Could you do it in the graphics before? Like on the, when you configure?
When I'm in the Oculus, in the Rift, I cannot change it. I'm gonna go check Joe. Joe had said they've made some posts about it. I mean, I wonder if they've updated how to fix that. Though there weren't other cars on the track, and it ran a hell of a lot smoother that time. So I don't know if it was cars or the fact that there was no crowd qualifying. I guess we'll just find out in the next race. All right. In the meantime, let's have a look in the forums.
I'm about to get in here and run a sub 1 minute lap.
In what, a hybrid?
LMP1? Yeah. Or pull, I'm about to pull like a 32-second lap here. Just go around the oval.
That won't work. Virtual reality. Oculus Rift optimization / help. That might be a place to look. This little post about optimization goes all the way back to 2011. I don't think that's up to date or useful. I got a voicemail, but my phone never rang. Oh.
Mason, what'd you run?
Hmm? What'd you say?
What did you run?
116.0.
Oh, what?
01.
Fucking hate you.
Huh?
I hate you. 16.078.
Huh?
So I'm and the slowest. Yay.
I'm gonna let you know, I would've went 15, but I screwed up coming out of that left-hander. Like, majorly. Like, I screwed up so bad, I made up 6/10 the next lap coming out of that corner. And I'm probably going to put it in the fence at the start of this race.
Turtles are rough, man.
Seriously, they're brutal. All of them.
So where do the INI files show up? Is that in documents or program files?
That I do not know.
The what now?
I want to change the render.ini. Wow. Hammer.ini. The render dx11.ini. There it is. Density.
Hey, I finally got it to stop dragging on the back end.
There we go. All right, loading up. And I did not qualify as well as you punks. Be right back.
Were you using the Robo, like, fix setup?
Was I?
Yeah.
I don't know, whatever one was in our drive I was using.
Shit. Good lap. I modified Alfala's setup.
I don't know if Fella put a setup out.
No, it was the one we had in our drive for Road America.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Or whatever said Alfala setup V1. All right, P1 again. How aren't you in the same race as me?
You're just that much better than me, man.
G is going to tell us where we're going to grid, right?
Yeah.
I'm P1 as well.
I wish it told you their qualifying times in here.
Yeah.
It does.
Oh, you'll find them. Where does it say them?
when you go to results, well, maybe it doesn't.
Boom, boom, boom.
Well, I think you can see them when you go, unless it's the practice time that shows up. But when I looked at standings, there was one guy that had a qualifying time after we gridded. Oh, yeah. I just loaded a lot faster than I was earlier. Still only getting 40 frames per second, though. It's still choppy.
Oh boy. Ooh, this was not a good setup to alter. I didn't look at the camera in the front. It's only 1.5. Good luck, gentlemen.
Some guy just said Watkins Glen seems like a good setup to run here. Yeah, until you get in the fucking oval, and then it's running the ground the entire time.
This time I actually did get it off the ground.
Well, I'm starting from the pole.
$115.9
That's what you got?
I guess so, yeah. What it's showing.
Yeah, you can look at the standings and see your qualify time. I'm the only one who turned a qualifying lap in my field.
Literally just me. Where are you at, Brent? P1?
3.
Oh. Second place car is pretty aggressive. I'm just going to let him wreck. Yeah, he's got an Eric Almirola paint scheme on.
Hey, there's nothing wrong with him.
He's got shitty colored letters with it, though. Don't match.
The car behind me just dumped all of the cones before you come up to the banking.
Just had a student email me. Did he honestly think I'm going to reply at 10 o'clock at night?
Why not,
concert
dude?
Tomorrow?
You're up, man.
I mean, I did reply, but...
Well, then what the fuck are you watching?
Alright, boys.
Good luck.
Pit stop clear all. Pit stop fast repair. Hey, one, cut it out. That doesn't do any good, and you almost hit me. I may have the pole, but oh shit. Spun on the first turn.
So did our leader, literally, first turn.
Oh my god! Oh, that was great. Y'all have to see that one. This guy just went airborne in the turtles.
Fucking 4X. Just ramming me in the back.
Whoa, that's my bad. I just, that just sucked. Sorry. Yeah, I'm still learning. I
forgot where I was and got on the gas way too quick.
Okay, I think I suck here. I don't know if it's because of damage, but my car will not turn right. Jesus. That's all me, man. I'm just...
Yeah, buddy. Second place spun.
Is there a way to actually set the resolution in the INI?
Told you that second place guy is aggressive. He must have just wrecked it and disconnected.
I just gotta stop and go because I had to dodge a car. Pit stop, clear all. Pit stop, clear all. So I did the fast repair. Coming out of the pits, there was a car blocking the exit of pits. Spun, and I got a black flag. Pit stop, clear all. Pitting. And I sped like a mofo into the pit, too.
I'm done. Destroyed my car.
Where were you running?
P2. That second chicane, or that first chicane, just screwed me over.
I guess I'll just have to bring another one home then.
Yep, I just blew it in the first chicane too. I'm gonna keep messing with these graphics settings.
Some guy almost wrecked me in the lead. He's a lap car and just lost it going into the second chicane. And he almost pulled a Jimmy Johnson.
Well, Jimmy wasn't a lap down.
Still though. Just trying to paint a picture for you, David.
Why would you paint?
Okay, Bagley.
God, I just got sandwiched. You realize this is going to be a disaster, right? In our season?
Nah.
So, like almost every other race?
They're going to have to turn the cautions off, right?
There are some good races in NIS. Yeah, there's not going to be cautions on here.
I think I found where to change the screen resolution. It did not save the pixels play. It overwrote it.
Second lead.
Ooh. Everything's in a different place now. Yeah, I don't like how this is looking. Everything is way out of whack. Got a better FPS, though. Oh, a nose planted into a turtle. This is quite terrible.
Where'd you end up, Brent?
I don't know. I wrecked out again, so I backed out. How'd you do?
P1.
Oh, P1. Good job, man.
Don't give me that shit.
What's that?
Said, don't give me that shit.
Yeah. I just want you to know I let those guys win. I wrecked out on purpose.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I had to readjust my... I had to change my... A lot of settings. I got into the next race. If y'all want to come in and get a good laugh. I'm on the pole again. I'm not on the pole. I'm in spot 3, but the other guys didn't grid.
No one grids.
Do what?
That would be hilarious if there was a race where no one gridded.
That would be kind of... That would be an interesting, like, special race. You know, like some kind of hosted funky thing. Just as a weird, different way to start the race. Everybody starting the pits.
Or handicap a fast driver by doing that. That's what the
just tried to wreck me.
Kicking people out. Make them start in the pits. Did you see that comment they had about manually starting your engine?
Yeah, I'm not having to do that.
Yeah, I know.
You've got to override that thing to do it.
I have the start button installed.
Yeah, no, you've got to go into your options menu and actually override it.
Oh, turn off auto start?
Yes.
Did you do it?
I did, yeah.
Do you feel like a real race car driver?
No, but I feel like saving fuel, so.
Ooh.
Well, I can immediately turn it off. I have both the ignition and the starter set.
So then why not just cancel that one extra step? Although in retrospect, it really doesn't matter. Like, it's not that big of a...
Well, that reminds me, I need to set my tear off.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. We're literally hitting the same button.
I used to have it, the Thrustmaster.
I've had some decent practice sessions, but my two racers haven't gone well, mostly on my fault.
It was perfect. Take a hand off, push it, come back up on the straightaway.
But I also just figured a way to improve my performance on my wrist, so hopefully I won't be getting as much lag now. The crowd definitely caused a hit.
All right, guys, I'm going to hang it up for tonight. Got a concert tomorrow, so I won't be on, but good luck racing this week.
Later.
Ooh, I got crossed over hard. The setting change that I made has given me a lot smoother look now.
Yeah, after an update like this, you probably should have, I think everyone should probably just redo their graphics.
Well, I had to go into my render INI and change something because I reduced the pixel density on the Rift setting. Well, the leader is just insanely faster than me. But right now I'm holding second. So I'm getting pressure from third. Leader's already five in front of me. Are y'all watching? Stream's up if you don't want a ghost.
No, I'm trying to do some editing stuff.
That guy's fucking fast. I've actually found a mark on one of the permanent tire streaks on the track for the last chicane. Oh my God, this leader is absurdly fast. We're on lap four and he's already got 13 seconds. Nope. Spun. Lost second. Damn it. Just gave up another spot from loose, getting loose. Oh! Ow. I just blew it going up onto the banking completely. Oh, this track is going to be a handful. Nope, never mind. Interesting. Anybody running the next one?
I'm not. I'm trying to find some free, uncopyrighted music is what I'm trying to find.
What, for streaming or for a video?
Video.
Mm-hmm. picky computer. That was an interesting place for it to freeze. I'm starting P2 this time. Do you remember offhand what 30 degrees Celsius is in Fahrenheit?
I do not.
29 degrees in Fahrenheit.
How much?
I'm talking to my phone. 29 degrees Fahrenheit? No shit. 29 degrees Celsius in Fahrenheit. Oh, it's 82. My crew chief just told me. So 30 is equivalent to about 83. Probably 84. I don't think I could ever memorize the formula, but I could memorize a few points, I guess. Like what 30 is and what 40 is. I know 40 is crazy hot, getting close to 100.
How come you don't run it in, is it because of the,
Cause I do so much in the,
and all that?
Well, I do so much in the sports cars, and you actually get more ticks on the pit road speed when you're looking at kilometers per hour instead of miles per hour, and so it's easier to stay right on the edge of not speeding.
Yeah, that makes sense. That's understandable.
Cause, like, you know, I'm, pit road, if... Instead of, like, on the big tracks, pit road is it's 80 kilometers an hour instead of 55, and I can usually get away with about 82 before it really will penalize me. Plus, in the Ferrari, the units of fuel is in liters, and so it's just easier to set the fuel by that. It's a little hard not to be too aggressive when it's a when you still know it's an unofficial race.
Yeah, you kind of gotta you kind of know that mindset, just giving it your all.
I'm not trying to run anybody over, but I'm definitely getting on the gas too much in some places and driving a little too deep in some places. You can blow the chicanes on the pace lap, can't you?
Don't know.
No, let's find out. Yep. I think I've settled on the graphics settings too. Wow, he's going to let me go into the chicane with him. Somebody said this track should be added to Carb Cup. I'm losing the most of my time in the first chicane or second chicane. And then I almost spun out again after turn one. Dropped two positions. I'm just not doing as well as you guys are. shit. Sorry, I lost control trying to dodge you. Wrecked out again. I think I'm going to do one more change.
All right, David, I'm out of here, man. Have a good night.
Later.
Yeah, stream.